my traumatic brain injury story. It was December 17th, 2013, when I picked up my mother to go Christmas shopping. I said, "Mom, put your seatbelt on." My mom asked, "Why? Why?" I replied, "Ma, because I could have an accident." Then I drove off. 3 minutes into the drive, I stopped at a red light waiting for it to change when I heard crunch. Someone ran into the back of my SUV. I said, "Ma, you see, someone just ran into me." So I drove across the street and parked my SUV on the center of the grass. While I was taking the lady's information and called the police, someone lost control on the road, drove up on the grass, and hit me while I was standing outside my SUV. My body flew like a rag doll and landed on the ground hard. Immediately, I went into a coma on impact. My mother sat there and saw everything. She was devastated. Lucky for me, police passing by saw the accident and my devastated mother. My mom attempted to touch me, but the policeman stopped her. He said, "Do not touch her. Let me see if she has a pulse." He bent down on his knees to feel for a pulse. He then said to my mom, "She is alive. I feel her pulse." Still on his knees, holding onto my lifeless hand, my mom asked him, "What are you doing now?" The policeman said, "I am praying for her." Then immediately, he called a trauma hawk to transport me to the trauma unit at the hospital. Because of those police officers, I had a greater chance of living today. Because the policeman was not in his jurisdiction, he had to leave as soon as I was transported to the hospital. While I was in the hospital and in a coma, two doctors walked in my room discussing a wound I received in the accident. One doctor said to the other, "If the wound to her side went half an inch deeper, it would have hit a major organ, and she would not have made it." Be careful talking about others while they are in a coma. They can hear you. We will never understand how the brain works, but all I can say is it's a mystery. In the hospital, I was told by the doctor I suffered a brain hemorrhage, a cervical spine fracture, lumbar fracture. I may not be able to walk, talk, and I'll be incontinent for the rest of my life. I was devastated to get that news. Trying to comprehend it all, I thought, how am I going to move forward in my day-to-day life now that I am disabled? I lay there in disbelief, trying to soak it all up, knowing my life is forever changed. But even after all this, I am grateful to be alive, even if it's meant a new way of life. After my traumatic brain injury, I cannot remember my name, my children's name, or my mother's name, but I recognize their voices. I had to learn how to walk and talk all over again. But most importantly, I am not incontinent in any way. Thank God for that. Overcoming TBI has its challenges, but as they say, life is one big road with a lot of signs. You just have to choose the right road to take. Today, I am happy to report to you that I am doing well. My backstory is, prior to my car accident, I had just finished writing my first screenplay, and because of my background knowledge with screenwriting, I can definitely say it has contributed vastly to my healing. Faster! Since my car accident, I went on to write two other screenplays, in addition to the one I had written prior to my car accident. I have written 7 children's books, and also invented a dance mat that encourages movements for all of life's situations. And that's a miracle. I can't begin to explain or express how, but it's the grace of God that I'm still here to share this story with you all today. As a traumatic brain injury survivor, we all still have our daily ongoing struggles with the after effects from our traumatic brain injury. Traumatic brain injury is real. It happens to you, and it happened to me. So if you are having a bad day, it's okay to cry, and it's okay to ask for help. Because if you are still here, that means you have a purpose, and nothing is going to take you out before your time. No matter how bad the situation looks, you will make it. You can do it. Take your life back and reclaim your power to a greater life that awaits you. To all the YouTube families, thank you for your support. Please don't forget to press the like button and subscribe to this channel if you like my content. Looking forward to sharing more of my stories with you soon. Your best days are ahead of you.